Hello everyone, how is everybody doing today? This is Steve Stallard with Johnson Plastics Plus. I have Joe Dovey with me, who is with Uninet. Let me bring out my PowerPoint here so we can actually have something. This is going to be an hour and a half of a PowerPoint meeting. Just kidding, that's not true. So basically, today we're going to talk about Uninet. We're going to meet Uninet, the product line. We've done some webinars on e-transfer and talked about the iColor. And we wanted to bring in the expert himself and talk a little bit about the line, do some live demos for you, just kind of go over a lot of things. I want this to be interactive. I don't have a PowerPoint other than a few slides here. So a lot of this depends on your participation and the questions you're going to ask. So I'm going to go ahead and just click through this. Right now, we can't see the screen. Hold on. Let me, a little technical difficulty here. Bear with me. Not sure why everybody can't see my screen. I can see me, but you can't see my screen. That's kind of weird. Well, Joe, can you see the PowerPoint I had up?
I cannot. I can see you though.
Okay. Show screen. Oh, okay. Change presenter. That's why. I'm going to make myself presenter. Show my screen. All right.
There we go.
Yeah, you think this would be my first day doing this? I promise it's not. All right. Okay, let me just minimize this here. Close this, bring this down, and voila. Okay, so if you're having any audio issues here, just again, restart your PowerPoint. That will probably solve that for you, or dial back in. If you can't hear on your computer, use the audio dial-in. So just a couple house cleaning tips. Also, we're going to do a question here, a poll. I just want to get an understanding of those of you on the webinar today, where you're at within your business, what technologies you're using, what technologies you might be interested in using. So I have two quick poll questions. So I'm going to launch those now. So, okay, everybody answer those questions. It's distributing now, so if you could take a minute and just click that, thank you. I see them coming in. We're at about 70% of you. Just a few more. Let's give it a little bit more time. Okay. All right, perfect. So we've topped out there. That gives me a good idea. So right now, about 76% of you are using sublimation today. 70% are using heat transfer. I'm going to guess a lot of that's probably heat transfer vinyl or some other technologies with heat transfer, UV LED, and laser. So let's go to that one. Let's go to the next poll. And we'll launch this one. All right, so if you guys can take time to answer that one for me. Okay, so about 60% of you are looking to add toner-based heat transfer technology to your business today. So that helps me understand where you're at. So I close that one. Let me exit out of here, bring back up my screen here, and we can bring this up, and we're gonna do, come back to here. I have Joe's website up. We're gonna go over a few things here in a moment. One thing I want to start out with, though, today is a demo. One of the things that we always get in our webinars is just, when are we going to get to a demo? When are we going to see a demo? So while I'm doing the demo, I'm going to let Joe talk a little bit about the lineup of printers that they offer, if you don't mind, Joe, starting out with maybe the iColor 550. But what we're showing today, just to kind of recap, maybe you're here and you're not sure what toner-based heat transfer is. So let's talk about that. So the toner-based lineup that we offer with Uninet is three models, the iColor 550, the iColor 600, and the iColor 800, which I have right over here. This is the 550. These are toner-based machines that you print to a transfer sheet, which I have one here, that you can do full color, self-weeding, and because it has white, that's the most important part of this, it has white, so that you can print dark colors on dark garments. So a lot of you have sublimation today, and you're probably here because you're looking for an option to do cotton and dark colors. This is the solution. And a lot of times we'll go over this, I get questions, which one's better? One's not necessarily better than the other. Each one of these has pros and cons, and they complement each other, and they're a good complement to each other. There's a lot of things that you're going to do within your business that you could use one or the other for, and one might excel at that. So we'll talk about that. So what I've done here is I've printed an image to a transfer sheet, and I have one done here. I'm going to do this in stages so that you can see it. So one of the benefits is there's a wide variety of sizes. This is 12 and a half by 19. As you can see, you can do a really big transfer with this, and I really wanted to show you that. I am not a little person, so you can see on here that you can get a nice size transfer. I wear extra large shirts. So this was done on the iColor 800W, and I will have Joe talk about that in a minute. But what you do is you print this with the printer, your artwork. You would design this in Corel or a Photoshop, whatever design program you're doing. You'd bring this over to the RIP software, and we're going to talk about the RIP. That's one thing different we're going to do today than we've done in some of our other webinars. Joe's going to talk about the importance of the RIP software, what you can do with the RIP software, and how it can help your production process and some of the tools that are within that. But what I've done here is I've printed to this. Now, this is for garments. The number one reason, at least, that most of my customers, probably 98%, buy this printer is to do transfers for garments. Now, we're going to talk about its other capabilities, because there's definitely things you don't want to overlook that you can add to your business with its capabilities. But let's talk about that. So you have a two-step, this is a two-step transfer, and this is an adhesive sheet here, and these two go together. And what we do is we press these two together. So what I'm going to do is come over to the heat press. And today I'm using the Stahl's Fusion IQ heat press. I know I'm off camera, but you guys can see. What I do is I'm going to take this here, and I'm going to put this on the heat press. So I place this face down, and it might be a little difficult. I'm going to try shifting the TV just a little here. How about that? Yep. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press this. Now, there's settings that you can store within this heat press. I really like this heat press. So right now, this initial press, we're doing at 311 degrees, 310 degrees. And we're doing probably a medium pressure, like a 4 to 5 bar pressure. And then we're going to press this for 110 seconds. So I'm going to get that process started. Joe, do you want to introduce us to your product line with like starting at the 550? Why I start doing sure. this?
Yeah, absolutely. So we have three machines to choose from. The entry level machine is the iColor 550. That's what Steve has right next to him there. That's got a retail price point of $36.95. So that's where it starts. So if you look at the machines really as three different sizes and customers that they fit, you have small, medium, large. So for $36.95, you have the entry level machine that will do basically letter A4 size printing. Up from that, you have the 600, which is a tabloid based machine. That's the $72.95 machine. And then the large.
I can show you. I brought that up.
Bring it up on the screen there.
Website here. Can you guys see that here? Hold on 1 second. I got too many things open.
There you go.
Yep, there is the 600. Okay, go ahead, Joe.
Right, and then the largest machine would be the 800W, which is to the right of Steve there. So that's $89.95 in the desktop version. So basically a version that would sit on a desk that you provide, and then $99.99 for the machine that you see there, which is on wheels and it has a storage card as well. The other difference between the $89.99 version and the $99.99 version, besides that rolling storage cart, is you get a 2-year warranty instead of 1 year. And you also get smart cut software included with that. So it's a pretty good value for that extra $1,000.
Perfect. And everyone, stay tuned. That smart cut's key. That's one of the most popular add-ons we're doing right now with that. I'd say just about every one of our heat transfer printers that's being added onto right now. And we're going to elaborate on that a little more here in just a second. We got about 26 seconds before I peel that. One of the other things I want to talk about, I'll start talking about it here and we'll continue talking about it. George, we have questions. Go ahead.
A real quick question while you're pressing there. I want to know what the pressure was for that press when you're doing the AP transfer.
Yeah, you don't want super high pressure. I do a 4 to 5 bar presser with that. That I find is a good pressure for me. All right, so right now, the key to this is you want to leave it on the platen. This is a hot peel. So what we're going to do is we're going to start down here. This might be a little hard to see. And I'm going to start peeling this off. And you want to do just a nice, slow, steady peel. You don't want to go too fast, because if you go too fast, you're going to peel your artwork off of the transfer and onto the glue sheet. And then you have a bad transfer at that point. So I know I don't have the best camera angle right now. I should have adjusted that for you guys. But we've got a great video on our Facebook page that talks about the two-step transfer process that Carly did. Go check that out. That's about a three-minute video that'll walk you through that process. So I'm going to pull this off. Okay. So now that I've pulled this off, you can kind of see I've got no glue here. You can kind of just see the outline of this thumbprint that I did, this giant colored thumbprint. So you can see here that I have no color on there. That's what you want to see. That's a successful peel. This sheet, when you're done with that, it's not reusable. That's a question I get a lot of times. When you're done with that, just toss it in the trash. And then here's my transfer. So what it's done, here's the front, okay? Now it has the adhesive backer to that. Now, one of the things to keep in mind, I talked about it's white toner. It prints white in the halftones. It underprints white with that. Now with two of the models, Joe, do you want to talk about underprint and overprint a little bit while I'm on that subject?
Sorry, I was muted. Yes, definitely would like to. So one of the key things with the iColor series of printers, in particular on the 550 and the 600 series, is it's not just a one-trick pony. The machine does heat transfer, like all the heat transfer printers do out there, like Steve just demonstrated. But we also have the unique ability to reorder the toner cartridges and switch the machine to an underprinting printer. And what that means is it's a completely different application for a different use. It's not for making shirts at all, or not for doing heat transfer. It's actually for printing on black and clear stock. So maybe a clear window cling, or clear labels, or black wedding invitations, that sort of thing, where you're printing directly on the substrate and you need to instead print white first and not last. It's a very unique function. There are other machines out there that do that, but they only do that. And they're in the $20,000 range to get a machine that prints white first. So it's a very unique offering, and you could do that right on that 550.
It is a nice add-on, because those are the things you want to look for. As you know, maybe your business has changed, or you have a customer that's doing this, finding those opportunities, especially in today's climate, of other things that you can use your printer for and creating other opportunities. We did a quick video, I believe it was a Facebook Live video that we posted on our website for printing cardstock on white. Go to our Facebook page, that's on there under the post of our video. You can see that video. I took a plain cardstock, we ran it through the iColor 550 from the bypass tray right here. We printed that out, it looked phenomenal. So that's something you can use that for. Now, underprinting and overprinting, that is an exclusive to the Uninet series of iColor printers, okay?
This
the
iColor 550
and 600. Yep, Joe's got one up in front of him right now.
So that's on black cardstock.
Yeah, that looks phenomenal. You see the colors that you're getting with that by printing on black cardstock? I mean, it's phenomenal.
And then this example would show what it looks like with an underprint and without.
Right. So you can see on that other image how light that is without that underprint. Yeah, that is huge that you're able to have a printer, not only you can do garments for it, but then print cardstocks for invitations or really anything, something somebody's looking for as far as that goes with cardstock. But it's a very versatile product. Then we haven't even touched hard surface items, which I got a bunch of those back there. Of items that we carry on jpplus.com to take a look at that. Joe, go ahead. I see you got something else there.
Yeah, this is a window cling. So another good example of why you'd want that white backer.
Yeah.
Behind the image. This would just stick on a window and look great.
Yeah, absolutely. So those are two things that you can definitely do with the iColor printers. I mean, it's a really unique function and you get that right out of the box. Okay. So now I want to jump back to the shirt demo. So I've now printed my transfer. I've pressed the adhesive sheet to the transfer itself. Now we're going to talk about the pressing process. So once I've got this ready here and I've pressed this and I put my adhesive backer on here, I want to do a quick trim around, because the design, the sheet is a little bit bigger than the glue sheet. So you want to make sure you clear off that glue line, which I've done here. It doesn't have to be fancy. I just ran my scissors around, as you can kind of see here. Now what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this back to my shirt and I'm going to line that up there. One thing nice about the Stahl's presses is it has this drawer pullout. It's a swing away, it's a drawer pullout. It's the only one on the market, this Fusion IQ, that that does that. It makes it very, very easy to load a shirt. Now, I'm not threading. You can thread. I just throw my shirt over top of the platen and adjust the pressure from there. But you can thread this on if you really wanted to. So it's a really convenient feature when you're pressing for garments. So I'm going to put that on. I blind this up. I'm also going to use these silicone sheets. You're going to get this with every printer package that we sell you. These silicone sheets are key. One, it's going to protect your transfer from top platen. It's going to make sure that nothing sticks to that as you're pressing it. And then it's also going to be used as a finishing sheet on your transfer after we've peeled this away. So we'll show you and talk a little bit more about that process here in a minute. So I'm going to go ahead and take this silicone sheet. And I'm just going to put two of them on here because, again, this size, 12 and a half by 19, is achievable with the 800W. And one of the things that you could do, and we'll jump into this, the smart cut. So let's say you have the iColor 550 and you want to do a 11 by 17 or a large print. With the smart cut software, you're able to do that because you can load your image into the smart cut software. It splits it up so that you can put it over two transfers and that you can press a tabloid size plus. So we'll talk about that more too and show you how that works. So I'm going to go ahead and press this. This is a 30-second press to the shirt. So I'll go ahead and press this now. Let's check in with everybody taking questions. Anybody got any questions for us? Not right now? Okay. Nothing right now. Joe, do you have anything you want to add to this process? Anything I've shown here?
Yeah. One comment on what you're doing right now. So I think you have that set at 310 degrees for 30 seconds. Is that right?
Yeah.
So just a tip for everyone to maintain color vibrance, you could actually knock that down to around 260 degrees. Yep. That would drastically improve the vibrance of that finished print. It's a little inconvenient to go back and forth between temperatures. Two presses would make that easier, but just a suggestion.
Yes, absolutely. So that's also nice if you're doing polyester shirts to drop that temperature, because you can, what you can worry about is dye migration. So if you're doing like a red or blue, when I'm doing my polys like that, I always lower those temperatures down too. And like Joe said, helps with color vibrancy too on your transfer. So once I've pressed that, this is a cold peel. So this one right now is super hot. The glue and everything's still meshy. You wouldn't peel this off because it wouldn't stick to the shirt. So I'm going to set this aside. I take it off gently. I've got one that is ready to peel. So I'm going to push this back. I'm going to have my handy assistant readjust the TV here in a second. Okay, so let's pull this. I'm going to go here so you guys can see the zoom in here a little bit. Yeah, perfect. Okay, so I've got one staged here so we don't have to wait. So in like in a production environment, what you would do is it takes an average about 3 minutes or so for a shirt. So you would start out doing all your A to B presses and then all your presses to your shirts and then all your peels and so forth. But I'm kind of just staging this out for you so you could see. But you want to let that transfer completely cool, as I said before. So what I do, I've got this on the shirt here. I'm going to go ahead and start the rolling process on this. So you don't want to just grab this and yank it off. You're going to have problems. You want to do a nice, easy roll. And I think everybody can see that on there. But I'm just going to start rolling this transfer off. Just a nice, easy roll. Just like this. And voila, we're done. So as you can see, no color, no toner left back on this transfer. That's a successful peel. If you're having issues or if it starts to lift off the shirt, you can stop, bring it back to the press, press it again for another 30 seconds, let it completely cool down, and then try rolling again. So I'm going to hold up the shirt here so you can see this. Now this isn't finished yet. You see how it's kind of got that gloss look to it? I'm going to hold it up, see it there? Okay, and again, this is on the 12 and a half by 19 paper. You can get a really nice big design. You know, everybody likes big full color and on dark colored shirts. This is achievable with the iColor printer. So I need to press this again. I'm going to take this back to the press. I'm going to press it for 30 seconds. And this is the finishing press, like a fixing press. George is moving the TV again. Sorry, guys. I know I'm all over the place. But I'm going to take this and I'm going to press this on the press here. I'm going to take this silicone sheet. I said before that you're going to use these at the beginning and at the end of the process too. So I take this and I bring it over. This fixing press is critical because if you don't do this, it's going to severely hamper the wash life of your shirt. So I'm going to bring this up, and I am going to press this again for 30 seconds. I have programmed my press here with the different times and temperatures, and I'm going to bring it on here, and I'm just going to press it. Joe, anything you want to add? Anything we're doing here as far as the finishing steps or?
Yeah, one comment, I guess. If you like that glossy look, you can get a glossy finishing sheet to keep that gloss sheen. Sometimes you want that, but more often than not, you want to mat it out. And a craft paper or parchment paper would do the trick. Just make sure it's siliconized. It needs to be silicone treated, or it could pull that toner right off the shirt.
Perfect. George, question.
I got a question for both of you. This one just came in, but Joe, maybe you can address this one. So the question is, do you think the transfer sheet technology will get to the point where you won't have to rasterize solid images and still keep washability? That's a loaded question, but you can handle that one.
I mean, as a general rule of thumb, we'd like you to rasterize a design that has more than three fingers together. Of toner. Okay, that's sort of the magic rule. So you see the image Steve has there is absolutely perfect because it has natural negative space. That's an ideal image for heat transfer. Negative space meaning the areas where the shirt itself shows through and is the color. So we didn't print black toner in those lines of the fingerprint. There's no toner there. And the shirt is creating the black. So that's the ideal type of image. But, you know, to answer your question, I think there'll always be a need for some type of rasterization on a really large design that are 3-4 inches or bigger. You really want to break that up and give the heat and wash water a place to pass through in the wash and the heat cycle.
Absolutely.
Hey, Steve, question for you. Somebody's asking, do I have to have that type of heat press to do heat transfer?
You know, I always recommend, well, first off, you need a good quality press. There's a lot of cheap Chinese presses out there that you can buy for next to nothing. And I know the technology is not inexpensive, and that's an investment. And then sometimes you say, well, can I save on a press? You're going to have problems with those presses in the long run. You want to buy a good American-made press. We carry Stahls, we carry Insta, we carry Geonite. This Stahls Fusion IQ is amazing. You want a swing away press, it's gonna be the most versatile press for you. This one again has the drawer pull out, the Geonites and Instas both swing away. So I always say stick with the swing away press. If you're already doing sublimation today, you most likely have a swing away press. And if it's an older model or something that's kind of giving you some trouble, because what can happen is, you need even heat and even pressure. And some of those cheaper presses, the components wear out and you're not getting even heat. The transfers are not inexpensive, and that's where most of your cost is. And that's so you don't want to be wasting those because you're getting phenomenal prints, but yet when you take it to your heat press, you don't have a good quality heat. And so when you go to do your peels, your A to B peels, it's causing issues. So invest in the good press. It's well worth it and going to save you a lot of hassle in the long run.
Yeah.
Let's jump, George, more questions?
No, we're good.
Okay. I want to talk about something now that we were just talking about artwork. Joe, I brought up the iColor graphics page here, talking about the books that you have available. Let's talk a little bit about that and what you have available there, because I get this a lot. Can everybody see that on their screen? Let's make this bigger. That's showing up. Okay. Joe, you want to talk about these a little bit? And I want to preface. So we get a lot of customers who are new to this that you're not comfortable with design or understanding what's the best way to design for white toner transfer printers. And as Joe talked about, you really want to cater to negative space within your artwork, allowing the background of the shirt to stand out, and then also rasterizing. That is crucial. So you want to talk a little bit about this, Joe, and some of these books that you're now offering?
Absolutely. We released this book because there's a great need to educate users on how to prepare artwork for white toner printers. You can't just download an image from Google and put it into the RIP and expect it to have great results. You need to design the artwork with white toner in mind. From that perspective, it's very different than sublimation. So this book teaches you how to set up that artwork properly, and we really stress the importance of rasterization and negative space in your design implementation. So the book itself, I think it's in a hardcover version is $99, and then there's a downloadable version that's a little bit less expensive, maybe $69. And that's available from Johnson Plastics. And you also have available to you four different graphic art libraries. Now, all the iColor printers come shipped with 25 graphics selected from these art libraries. So you can test out the artwork and see how you like it, but it's all ready to go for a white toner printer. It's already prepped for you. The most you'd have to do is just do what we call a knock me blackout. It's just a process where we remove the black and the rip to let your shirt color show through. Otherwise, they're ready to print. So there's four graphic art libraries. Each one has 500 graphics for a total of 2,000. And that's also available in a hardcover with a dongle, a physical dongle that we ship you, or you can have a downloadable version that's a little bit less expensive. And I think on that site, there's actually PDFs that you can download that shows you all the graphics. They're all watermarked, but you get an idea of what's included.
Yeah, absolutely. This is huge for you. If you're just getting into this, I know design is hard. I mean, shoot, I know enough just to be dangerous. And I'm always having our designers on our marketing team fix stuff that I'm messing up. So this is really going to help you get a base. And by adding in these books and then being able to use those, here's an image of the other volumes. So you have here, there's four volumes in the artwork here, and you can download the previews with that. What we're going to do starting in September here, as a special, any of the white toner transfer printers that you purchase with us with the Uninet line, I'm going to include the white toner transfer book for you on setting up your artwork, so you can get a good understanding of that. That's this first book you see right here, and then available for purchase, you can then do these other volumes too. But I definitely recommend that for you.
Hey, Steve, we had a question about artwork. Should it be CMYK or RGB for the files for the Uninet printers?
Joe, why don't you touch on that one? We get that a lot.
We get that question constantly. CMYK is preferred. The problem is you're not designing in CMYK, and that's not what you're using. So I get it. You want to use Photoshop. Photoshop is not CMYK native. It would be RGB because that's for raster images. So we just ask if you're going to design in Photoshop before you're done exporting your design, just save it as a CMYK, a PDF, or a PSD file that would retain the vector-based format and CMYK format.
Yep. Keep in mind, opposite of sublimation. So a lot of you are doing sublimation where you need to design an RGB. So keep in mind, this is opposite. It's important to do it as CMYK. It's important to this process and this technology. So we've answered some questions there. Joe, let's jump over to the RIP software. We want to do that. Let's do that right now. Let me make sure I got you as presenter. George, do we have any other questions we want to answer? Are we good there?
No, we're good for the moment.
Okay. All right. Okay, so great. All right, Joe, I think you are presenter. I'm making you presenter. So you should be able to share your screen.
Yeah, let me just make sure we're, what do you guys see there?
Are you seeing Joe's screen? Yep, I see it here. Yep, we're good.
Which screen? I have three monitors in front of me.
I see the iColor 550, the Swiss Army knife of the printing world.
Good. Okay.
Take it over.
Okay. So I just want to bring up this one slide. This is a 28 slide show, but we're just going to show you this one slide because if there's one thing to remember, it's the versatility of the iColor line of printers. That is what is different. We get that question all the time. How is your products different than the other printers out there? Here's what you need to know. They do the same thing, but in addition to doing those things, they do these other things. So it's really five printers in one. An iColor printer is at its very base a overprinting printer. So where I have here white overprint, it means it prints white last because white really will become the background color when you flip that image around, right? So you want white on top, then you place it on your shirt, then white becomes the background. That's called white overprint. The unique thing we do is we can do white underprint. We talked about it before. We're printing white first and blocking the substrate color. And that's not for heat transfer. It's for printing on black paper, clear paper. You actually could use it for heat transfer in a way. You could do hard surface transfers with an underprint and then print to the backside of glass. So, you know, Johnson Plastics has a great line of acrylic blanks, clear acrylic. You can print to the back of that and look through that glass to see the image. That's a really cool look. It's kind of 3D and it protects it. So that's one example of why you might want to use a white underprint for heat transfer. But beyond those two functions, we also include a black toner cartridge with our 550 and our 600 printer. So it is a regular CMYK printer. You can print all your office documents, your invoices, posters and banners, all that sort of stuff So it's nice to have the black toner included. It's also a fluorescent color printer. And we know, you know, there's other fluorescent color printers out there, but they just do fluorescent color. This machine is not limited to any one function. You can just take the cartridges out, put the fluorescent colors in, and you have beautiful fluorescent color that glows under black light. I should mention the white toner that comes with the iColor printers is already fluorescent. You get that in the box. It's nothing you need to purchase extra. It glows under black light, which looks really cool, but it also makes the colors look really bright and vibrant. So that's a nice advantage. Additionally, it's a dye sublimation printer. So you don't have to choose between, you know, your Epson or a Sawgrass printer or an iColor printer with that has white toner printing capability. You have both in this machine. So you can take out the cartridges it comes with. You can add the optional dye sublimation toner kit, and you have very high yield, very high speeds. You have another advantage in our dye sublimation technology in that you don't need to use special transfer paper. It uses regular plain copy paper. So super fast, 30 to 40 pages per minute. You don't have, you know, the drying out issue or the expiration that you might experience with an inkjet system. So really, really nice option. That's it. That's what it does. So there's, you know, 5-in-1 printers. All right. So we're going to bring up the RIP. Are there any questions on that?
Questions? We good, guys?
Yep, we're good.
Okay, great. So here I have the RIP in front of us. This is our ProRIP software. And I just want to cover a couple of cool things we can do with the RIP. I think a lot of people are intimidated when it comes to the RIP. You know, our competition ships the printers with a driver, okay? A driver does nothing more than layer, 300% layer of white over all of the design elements, which is probably too much white in many cases. It makes the image a little heavy. It makes it expensive to print because the white toner is quite expensive. It's really not necessary to use that much white. So the solution is to add a RIP. Now, a RIP package is around $600. The good news is the iColor printers all ship with the RIP included in the box. There's no additional charge for the RIP. It's included. So this is what it looks like. You'll notice that you have three print queues set up on our 550. You have an overprint queue, you have an underprint queue, and you have a CMYK queue. That's the three ways that you can print. And if you look at the bottom right here, there's a little pictogram that changes. So you could see this one has the black toner installed. It tells you exactly how to configure your printer. And when I click underprint, the white toner cartridge goes to the back. And when I click overprint, the white toner cartridge comes to the front. Okay, so as long as you match your cartridge orientation with that picture, you can't get into any trouble. Most of the time, you'll use the overprint queue. That's where we are here. Let's just bring an image in. We include images with ProRIP. So let's bring in.
Joe, we have a question. Can we have George chime in real quick while you're doing that?
Yep.
A couple questions here. The first one was, how much toner is wasted when you change cartridge, or is there any that's wasted when you're changing cartridges?
Zero.
That's a great toner. Zero. Yeah, there's none.
Yeah, there's no maintenance at all with these printers. None. So you can immediately go from one toner set to another set. It's not like there's an ink delivery system that you might be familiar with that has tubes and nozzles that might clog. So the very first page out will be the new toner because Steve, can you pull out one of the cartridges and show them out of that 550? So the unique thing on the 550 specifically, and this is just on the 550 series, is the drum cartridge is actually integrated into the toner cartridge. Okay, so that's the toner side, and flip it around, that's the drum. It's all one piece, which means when you take it out, every bit of that toner is out of the printer. The other thing it means is when it's time to replace your toner cartridge, you always get a fresh drum, and that's very unique. The only printer, white toner printer on the market that has that functionality. Even our 600 series doesn't do that. So you'd have to change the toner and the drum separately and maintain those two consumables. So it's a really nice advantage that you always have a fresh drum.
I want to touch on something real quick too that I just appreciate and love that you guys do. You'll notice in your iColor, Uninet labels all these to tell you exactly how to place the paper, whether it's in the bypass tray or in the drawer. And it also tells you here at the top, they add these stickers here to tell you at the top, as far as standard printing and spot color printing, where the printer displays and what you replace it with. They really make it easy for you to understand if you are swapping toners or changing things, how to put them in here. And it's right here as a reference. Sorry, Joe.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah, and to that point, in that MPT tray you just closed, you'll notice there's a label that says what side the paper goes up or down. Believe it or not, that used to be a question we get all the time. People are printing the wrong side. So little things like that, we try to make it easy. If you opened up the tray on the bottom, you'd see there's also a label that tells you what side the paper goes up or down. So we just try to hit all those
print side up.
Yeah.
That way you're not wasting transfers and you know right away. Yeah.
Okay, so I brought in, are there any more questions or?
Yeah, we do have a few here. The first one was, is this still a true dye sublimation? How does the sublimation work? And does sublimation have white when you're talking about the iColor 550?
It's different. It's a toner-based sublimation. So you have aqueous-based sublimation like we sell with the Sawgrass, and then you have a toner-based sublimation. With this toner-based sublimation, you still don't have white because the particles cannot gas in white because of the titanium particles that are in it. They're too large. So this is you can add sublimation toner to this toner-based sublimation. So it's not aqueous-based like you're used to with like our Epson line or the Sawgrass line. And Joe, add anything you want to that.
Yeah, I mean, sublimation rules still apply. It's not magic. It has to be white polyester. That's all you can imprint on. But the benefit is you just have the one machine. You don't have to maintain two. And the real benefit is there's no maintenance, right? If you're familiar with some of the inkjet technologies out there, they are amazing. And they're awesome because the cost of entry is very low and the resolution and the color is outstanding. The downside is you have to use it every day or at least often, very often. And if you don't, you can have dried ink nozzles or you don't have any of that with the laser based. If you just plan to do it occasionally, this is a better solution.
Yep. Okay, we're good on questions.
All right. Okay, so okay, great. I brought an image into the RIP just to show you a couple of things that you can do. So this image is here. Let's say your customer provides this image to you and they're asking for left chest pocket designs, and you'd have to take this logo on the bottom and crop it out in Photoshop or something. You can actually do that right in the RIP. I just click crop right here, and I can just zero in exactly on what I want to keep. Okay, so I just have this one little cropped image on a big 8.5 by 11 sheet. So that's not going to work. I'm going to click copies. And what that will do is double up this image. Just takes a moment to render.
And while Joe's doing that, I actually used this today, but I didn't do a full sheet here. I just was in a hurry. But I took one image, I put it on here, and then I copied this all across. You don't have to do that in your design software. He even cropped it out of another image. So I'm going to press this on a mask here in a little bit too, so you'll see.
You could see how easily we just duplicated that image. Yep. And you can even add a little bit of space and open it up and then center it. So that's how simple it is to, you know, crop and duplicate and maximize that transfer paper, because the transfer paper is the most expensive part of the process. You know, the toner is it's minimal. It's almost inconsequential. You know, it's 10 cents or 15 cents, or if it's a super saturated image, it could be 30 cents, let's say, but it's very small compared to the transfer paper. So we really want to use that transfer paper wisely. This function lets you do that. Okay, so that's cropping, duplicating, and layout functionality. Let's show another option here. Just going to bring in some artwork.
And one of the things I want to discuss with everybody here as you're evaluating this, don't let this RIP software scare you. You know, that we, as a part of our package, that when you buy a printer with Johnson Plastics Plus, we're going to do your install and training for you. And you're going to have a lot of questions, and that's okay. You know, you can give us a call as much as you want. The RIP software is very intuitive. If you can't figure something out, you give us a call. We'll help you walk through it. But when you get started, we're going to make sure you understand how to do the basic functions that you're enough to be dangerous and start running transfers.
So this image that we brought in has a lot of black in it. And, you know, we talked about it before. Black is actually the least used element in all of your design artwork because you're printing on black shirts most of the time. I mean, we understand that if it's a white shirt, you might use sublimation. For black shirts, this is the only option. We don't want to reproduce the color black on a black shirt. It won't look good, it won't feel good, and it's expensive to do it that way. So we can bring an image in as long as it's a non-vector-based image, a raster-based image. We can just go to jobs and then production plugins, and we're going to choose knock me blackout. And what this will do is look at the image and identify all the black elements, and just leaving everything at the default values, it will go and pull all those black elements out. And that's ready to print now on a black shirt. As soon as this comes back.
That is huge that you don't have to take that to a design software or do anything there within a click of a button, pull out that black and be ready to run that transfer. And that's key. Anytime you go pull out those dark colors, because again, we're not going to want to reproduce that black, so you can press it to the shirt. It's really nice. That is going to be a function you most likely will use quite a bit.
Okay. So let's pull that out. Let's bring another image in. Okay, here's an image that we brought in that's 11 by 17. So this is too large for me to print on my 550. So in this case, what we want to do is use the Smart Cut software and split it.
And stay tuned. What we're going to do this week while Joe's working on that, I'm going to do a Facebook Live video that we'll post where I print an image and I show you the process of taking those two and then marrying a backup on the shirt. We're gonna do a separate video for that. So stay tuned this week. Here coming up, we'll post it to our Facebook page.
Okay, you'll notice that Smart Cut is now integrated directly into the RIP. And for users out there who have this already, you may not see this, but it's a free update. Okay, so you can just contact your dealer or UniNet and we can give you a license upgrade. And you'll now have Smart Cut integrated directly into the RIP. So you see this option under jobs that says split image using Smart Cut. That will immediately launch Smart Cut and bring your image into interview. Okay, so now we're going to choose two page sizes to split this. Let's make this a little smaller. Okay, so the idea here is you want to create an area of overlap. And here what we've done, you see this pink box on the left and this blue box on the right. You want this portion where they intersect is the area where the image will be split. And you want to give that as wide of a space as possible to let the software do its job. So this is a graphic. We're going to click split. We're going to choose here that it's a dark garment. And the reason why you want to choose dark garment is the RIP will look at the areas, the darkest areas, and put the split lines through that area. Because we know in the RIP software, we're going to remove those black areas. So you won't see where they get seamed together. So it's go ahead and split them. I'll click save and yes. And you'll notice now Smart Cut will close. The image that we brought into the RIP will disappear originally, and it'll be replaced by two images. And each one of these images is the left and the right side of that split image. So here you go.
Well, he's doing that. George has another question for us, Joe.
Yeah, he wanted to know what software comes with the printer. Does this software come with the printer, or and what comes with the printer?
Great question. So the iColor Pro RIP is included in every printer. The Smart Cut is an add-on that we can add to your package, and it's added on quite often. And I would definitely recommend it. So that is an add-on. The update that Joe's talking about now adds it within the rip. And the Smart Cut is an add-on option that you can add to any of the printers. It's been super popular with the 550.
Yeah, so keep in mind, just to clarify, because we do get a lot of questions on this, you'll always see this Smart Cut integration over here where it says split image with Smart Cut, and it will open, it'll work, but there'll be a watermark across the image. So with a paid license, that license I think is $349, which can be sent virtually, so you can even add this later, no problem. It's just a file that Johnson Plastics will send you, but that will remove the watermark. So you'll always see that integration. It's there, but it'll have a watermark until you unlock it. Okay, so here's your two images. They're ready for printing. You'll see, I mean, they're going to line up perfectly. You will not see any seam when you put this together. Just keep in mind, we're removing that black area. So while you might see this harsh line right here, you know, you're going to do that knock me blackout function, and there won't be any black there at all. So where they're stitched together, there's actually no toner there.
Yep, super convenient. Just another tool in your arsenal that if you add that Smart Cut software, that you'll be able to do. And again, we'll do a live demo of that we'll post to our Facebook page, where then I'll show you the marrying process and everything.
Yep, so there you go.
Anything else you want to show there, Joe, on that? Sorry, I didn't mean to talk over you.
That's okay. Nothing more on Smart Cut. I think one more thing might be interesting is the fluid mass functionality.
Yes, absolutely. Please show that. Any other questions? Nope, still good? Okay.
So yeah, we do have a question. I'm going to run over here. We do have a question.
Okay.
The question is, who do they contact to get an upgrade for the RIP software? This customer has both, but not the integrated version. So they wanted to know how they get the upgraded version of the RIP software.
Yeah. Now, Joe, that came out as an update, right? So if they have Pro RIP today and they run the update, that should show the integrated version, correct?
Yeah, it should now. It was just pushed live recently. So assuming your license is new enough, you can do an update. If your license is not new enough, like if you're still using V1 software, you're going to need a new license. It's free, but you just need to contact iColor support to get that.
Okay.
There we go. Thank
you. All right. Thank you.
Okay. So here I've brought in this image of this handsome guy here.
And looks familiar.
Yeah. So the problem with an image like this, it's not really ideal for heat transfer because there's a background, right? You wouldn't want to print that gray square on a shirt. You just really want to print the image itself. So we can click Edit with Fluid Mask. Fluid Mask will then open in the same way that Smart Cut did before. It's integrated. And you have this red wand, and all you need to do is just sort of click the area you don't want. And Fluid Mask will go through and create a mask out of that. Just click File and Save and Apply. Again, the image will disappear. It'll come back, but this time it will come back without that background. This is super important because the artwork that your customers may send you will not be ideal, and you will need to remove those backgrounds quite often. So here's a quick
one. I just want to stress how easy that was, that you don't have to go to your design software. You can bring that right in, edit that with Fluid Mask, pull out that background within a couple clicks. So
yeah, it's super easy. Nice. Works great. Okay, that's what I have for the basics on ProRIP and Smart Cut.
Perfect. Any last questions on that? Before I do one last demo, one of the things I want to talk about that here is hard surface items. Joe mentioned it. I've got some just products to show you. So don't forget about the hard surface capabilities. We have a variety of hard surface papers available, and we sell a variety of products on our website that this can go in. This product here is part of our home decor line. Again, this back paneling pops out. This is also UV printable, but what we've done is we've heat transferred this. So this has been heat transferred onto this product full color. Again, another way to use your heat transfer printer. Again, this is a Romark wood product that would be in your laser that's been cut down from a sheet. And then we applied a heat transfer to this. And again, this is something here that would be like an interior product or something like that, that you could hang up as a signage opportunity, something along those lines. But again, used with the hard surface paper on the Uninet printers. Drinkware is another option. You got it here. This is on a mug that would be sublimatable, but here we did a heat transfer on it. But anything that's not sublimatable, you could go on. So really, I kind of give a rule of thumb. If it can take heat, fit in a press, you can most likely put a transfer on it. It's working through the process and time, temp, whatever, all that good stuff. But there's a lot of products that you can put a transfer on: wood, metal, ceramic, glass, all those good things. Some of the sublimation items, it doesn't have to be. So if you wanted to do full color image on a dark colored mug, you could do that by using a hard surface paper with your Uninet and the iColor products here. So I wanted to talk about that.
One more note to that. If it cannot take heat, you have the option of using the tattoo paper or the aqua clear or water slide paper is a great option.
Yep, absolutely. Those are available. We sell all those papers on our website, jpplus.com. You can see the variety of papers. We're going to be adding some additional products here as far as papers soon. So that's a growing product category for us. I want to end with just another demo. Just kind of show you masks. That is, everybody's making them. And, you know, maybe you don't have a dye sublimation printer and you want to do heat transfer. And again, you can do sublimation with these. So you could do sublimation if you bought the toners, but let's say you had a black mask. You're not going to sublimate onto that, okay? So how can I do full color? So I've used our two-step paper here. I've got a logo. So this would be like, it says Grill House, the barbecue and steak. So this would be maybe a logo and a presses to this that would go on here and that you could do for restaurants or really anybody who needs a mask, any business that you could put a logo on. But again, I'm going to press this to the mask. If we have questions, George, go ahead and fire that away.
Turn a little bit here, Steve, so people
can see. Oh, good. All right. So again, I'm just going to take this back to my heat press. I'm going to take my image here that I've already done. I know it's hard to see on here. Let me try to get up in here. You got white on there. Let's see if you can see that. Maybe turn here. I'll show you when I get it on the mask. It'll be easier. So we've gone through just like all those steps before, the printing, the pressing of the A to B and everything. I've got this already. So I'm just going to put this on the press. I am going to put a silicone sheet over top of this. And we are going to press this here for 30 seconds. I'm adjusting my press a little bit here just to kind of feel out the right pressure. And I'm going to press that on here. Now I'm going a little heavier on this because the thicker part of the mask or it's sewn, I want to make sure that I get enough pressure on that. I'm going to press it for 30 seconds. So again, wide variety of products that you can go on with heat transfer, more than just shirts. So hard surface items and other type of garments are available there too. Joe, anything you can think of that we missed or I didn't cover that you want to add?
I think you covered it really well, and we hit on the points here. I mean, the key is that heat transfer is very, very versatile.
So now I press that on there. Now, George, I'm going to let you readjust here.
Yeah.
And if you've ever been to a trade show and come and talk to me at the trade show or really any vendor, I'm going to do the old fanning trick here. So usually at a trade show, I'm sitting here talking, trying to fill the time before I cool this. So here's what I'm doing. So if you're in a hurry and you need to get something done real quick, this is a good way to do it. You can just fan that transfer. Having a cooler surface helps because you want to get that completely cool. So I just flip that over and put it face down on this table so you can see that. I'm just going to fan this.
Hey, Steve, we did have a question. Actually, it's just a little bit of a housekeeping issue. Somebody asked if the webinar was going to be available after we're done here.
Yes.
It will. It'll get posted to our website at jpplus.com/workshops. You'll see it there. Give us a little bit of time. It won't be immediately right after the webinar here, but sometime today we should have that link up. And you'll also get an email with that link as well.
All right. So I think I've got that pretty cool here. And I'm just going to do that rolling process that we did before. And I'm going to roll that transfer off. And there we go. Now I've got this. I'm going to get as close as possible. I'd press this one more time. But now I've got a colored logo with white on a dark colored mask. So again, another thing you can do with your heat transfer. Masks are selling like crazy. You jump on that bandwagon and pump out those masks. and you can do those transfers. Now, again, you're not going to want to do a full transfer across this mask. You're going to want to cater to negative space, something like this in the middle. You can still do a larger image. Make sure you rasterize it if it's too big. But yeah, we've covered everything. Again, any questions, please contact us. All the printers are listed on jpplus.com along with the e-transfer papers and other products that we carry, substrates that you can use on the hard surface. You can also put the heat transfers on. Joe, really appreciate you joining us today, going over the full product line, and we'll have you back again soon to go over some more stuff.
Thanks so much, everyone.
Yep, thank you. Everybody have a great day.